Okay, we have iPhone 11 Pro Max. This device is suddenly unable to turn on. First thing, take out the board and to check with the power supply. Let's see what kind of problem we got. So connect the cable. And this is iPhone 11 series cable. And give him a little voltage. So before the voltage reaching 1.0, he already take a lot of power. The current is already leaking. Okay? This is what we call short. Okay? The motherboard is short. So double confirm. Let's use the multimeter and then measure the related pin. Okay, this is the connector. Okay, it's confirmed. Its resistance become zero. Okay, the diode value become zero. Mean is it short? This line shouldn't be like this. Okay. So yeah. So first thing, we're gonna use the thermal camera and to see is any short on top of the layer, okay, top of the motherboard. Okay, maybe one of it is the problem. So we'll continue to use the power cable. So now we are looking at the thermal camera, give him a voltage. So none of the things on top get heat up, only the cable get heat. So anyway, we need to take a look in behind also. Okay. Behind seems nothing, but actually internal, they have a lot of components, okay? Okay, so we can't see in this way. We must need to remove the board. Okay, after we separate, immediately we check any broken parts or not, okay? So from what we see, it seems fine. Then we use the multimeter to check again to see, okay, only the up layer of here, the battery connector there, is it still short or not? So we have resistance on the connector here. So mean the top layer doesn't have the problem. So what's next is we need to check the lower board, which one is the main power line, because the top board power IC transfer the voltage to the lower board. Okay, let's look at our software ZXW. Look for iPhone 11, 11 Pro Max. Okay, 11 Pro and Pro Max, they are the same. So now I'm going to show you if the power enter from here and it is no short. Okay, we're going to look at next section. Okay, so all the section here is the top board, the lower board is this part. Okay, so I'm going to measure the resistance of here. The SIM holder is on the right side and then there's a few packs on here. Okay, so see the value of here is zero. Okay, there shouldn't be zero. So mean the short is coming from the lower board, also known as the baseband board. So next step is we do the jumper. Okay, so the black one, I just click on the SIM holder here, and the red, I just connect to the voltage line of here. Okay. So now I'm gonna use thermal camera again. Okay, so looking at the lower board, it seems like hard to see and nothing until you get the temperature. Okay, so we see this dot giving the heat. Okay, it's right on here. I point at here. So this cap seems like this one. Okay, so let's turn off the voltage and see again. Yep, when we do the blinking, this guy blink together, it means he is leaking. Okay, this capacitor is leaking. I'm gonna just take off like this way, okay, to see whether I can borrow the strength of the next capacitor or not. Okay, yep, I can, but not gonna borrow the strength of the IC. Okay, it's dangerous. So now check the current again. Okay. So when we're reaching 3.8, it is nothing short anymore. So make sure the voltage. Okay, you're resuming. The power is entering the board, no problem. Turn off the voltage. So we will need to replace this guy, okay? There's still many caps. There's still many spare caps on surrounding, okay? Here, 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 here. Have many. So just missing one, it will still be fine. Okay, no problem. So now the next step is to reinstall back. So we have two ways. Either we reinstall back without reball, okay? That one, we'll have a risk. The customer might return when he just dropped the device a little, okay? Cold solder, you know, okay? Cold joining. So if we reball it, the board will fully join. Will be more tight. So I'm going to reball it. Is working now. No SIM install, no Touch ID is because I haven't connected the Touch ID components. Okay. Alright. Hi, you must be wondering how much to fix this kind of problem. I really cannot tell you that. That is because not every problem is the same. There will be hundreds of the reason the phone become dead. So you really need to send a professional if you want to find out how much cost to repair it and what's the damage. And do not expect that don't charge you a small fee if you're not going to repair it. As you can see in my video, we need to dismantle a lot of things and then reassemble all the things. Also, iPhone motherboard technician, they are like a surgical doctor. Different doctor, different price. I guess you can understand what I mean. So if you need our help, just check out our website. So I'll see you on the next video. Bye. Okay.